myself is Subhasmita and I am going to address some features which are need to be explored while before developing application. So let us first understand what is e-learning. E-learning is the process of delivering, as you know, e-learning is the process of delivering educational education and material by electronic means that can be by asynchronously or synchronously. So but there are various issues in e-learning education, like classification of learner needs and behaviors. Different learner have different build process and storing of knowledge. So they first need to be classified into groups, and accordingly the education should be given. So the points to be considered while developing an application is keeping the navigation clicks to a minimum. These are various points, I will explain this later. Keeping the navigation click to a minimum. If we will develop an application and we will have a lots of navigation clicks, and we have to scroll it to we have lots of scrolling, then this user using it may get bored and he may not get what may not obtain what he is trying to learn from that. And we also need to develop application which can run perfectly in both low and high connection speed, and we should have a consistent user interface. But there exist some problem in current e-learning application that this system do not really allow for diversification at all, and we will present as this current e-learning method presents the same sequence of learning to each and every user. So the so one solution could be course designer should specify which material should be delivered to which learner and what time, but this requires time and effort. So in order to avoid this, we can select material for user with different learning style automatically, thus removing the burden from the course designer. This distinction can be made based upon the learner's past experience and prior knowledge. These are the various types of student behaviors. By observing this behavior, we have to develop application, because like this one type of behavior is the struggler who studies less frequently than all other students. So while developing application, we must need to focus these students also, so that the learning can be more interesting for them, and so that they can grab much from that. These learning behaviors are obtained by the social and cultural factors. These are the technological issues which already Pawan has explained. The usability, that the application developed should have usability, functionality. These are general while developing any application, means not for only this. Usability means the application developed should be usable, that is understandable, learnable, friendliness. And functionality means the system must include all the necessary features that are accomplish the required task. And the system reliability means the system should be reliable, that should not crash, or it should be fault tolerant, or multiple users like can use them. And efficiency, like system response time, performance, as well as the pace and graphic generation speed, must be high enough to satisfy student need. And the maintainability means that the application should be easily maintained, and the analyzability and changeability etc. need to be considered. Educational e-learning environment, there are two types of e-learning environment, like functional environment and mobile environment. In functional environment can be said to be synchronous way of learning, but mobile environment can be asynchronous, because here the user gains knowledge while in motion, that is dissemination of pedagogical material through the use of wireless network and device. We use the various techniques like WLAN, WAP, SMS and UMTS, but in this case we give some assignment and they immediately get the feedback also. So there also exists some personal preference section where the system provides access to the email and a regular progress report, homework submission utility, and they contact their peer to know their regular daily progress. This diagram shows the whole process of e-learning engineering, like first the formulation, what needs to be developed first to be understood, like what is the goal and the goal of the e-learning, and then planning need to be done about the estimation of the cost and the risk associated, and then another user requirement and the system requirement is analyzed against the system content. Then the engineering phase comes, which consists of two parallel paths. Like first one is the content design and then production, and the second one is the architecture design, navigation design and interface design. These two paths continues parallelly, and then page is generated, e-learning page is generated and tested. Then student faculty evaluate, and then they change and if modification is required for the application developed. The opportunities involved, like these points already Pavan has explained, that explanation voice and explanation combining voice and evolving graphics, the learner need to develop a model inside his brain by combining the voice and the graphics collected from the learning. And then active learning simulation. In simulation, since we cannot practically connect all real time devices in reality to check how is it functioning, so we do a simulation where the user can visualize what is actually happening in the real world. And likewise, active learning, here the user actively collect the information, then organize, then integrate them. And the problem solving with individual instantaneous guidance and feedback facilities also there in e-learning. And student also ask questions, and timely assessment is there, they contact with their peer, and then their performance is reviewed. If we include diagrams in our e-learning, then it also helps to visualize more easily, but it is not the case always, as sometimes lots of irrelevant diagrams may detract the user from gaining knowledge. Like suppose we will add a diagram to molecular level diagrams, then it will be relevant and provide better performance. But if there will be more diagrams, then in that case also there will be failure. But how to know how to select pictures, and how to know that whether the diagram will help in improving the learning gain? So Mayer and Knowles proposed two models with the assumption that 12 channel processing, limited capacity working memory and active processing. In 12 channel processing, as we have two ways to access processing the visual information and verbal information, so the dual channel processing assumes that we the information that traverses from our eye to brain takes one path, and from ear to brain takes another path. But we have only one brain, so there is limited capacity inside the brain to be processed. At the time, only one thing can be processed. And active processing means the user here integrates the knowledge gained via different sensory organs. There lies difference between the Mayer and Knowles model. Mayer proposes that pictorial and verbal mental model are created independently, then they are integrated. But Knowles proposes that a single integrated mental model is created that takes into account both pictorial and verbal content. So while considering for effective diagrams, we need to determine whether a particular diagram will enhance learning. So first we need to understand the objective of developing that e-learning application. Like if it is very abstract type, then the diagram is a must in that case. And if we include a diagram, then we must analyze first that whether how much information to be shown in the diagram, whether we need to show the diagram in black and white or using color. Then learner's cognitive process and prior knowledge also is a main point, because if the learner has prior knowledge about the thing, then diagram is not that much required. These are two versions of learning. One is consisting only of text, and other one is consisting of the diagram. Then 170 students were taken, and they were divided into three groups: lowest performing group, medium performing group, and higher performing group. And when they were taught by using this method, and some group were taught by this method, then it was found that the performance of student using this diagram method was high. They were considered by taking their marks as measurement. Now there are lots of applications available nowadays, computer application for learning. So I will cover only one application, that is Fuzzy Logic Toolbox. This is a type 2 fuzzy logic toolbox, which is written in MATLAB and Simulink. So the main aim is to help the user to understand and implement the type 2 fuzzy logic system. And fuzzy type, you might be knowing that type 2 fuzzy system is an extension of classical fuzzy one, fuzzy set. So the output, the main difference between the type 1 and type 2 is that type 1 only deals, output of the type 1 is crisp output, but type 2 deals with uncertainties. And the type 2, this toolbox provides a simple point and click interface that guides the user effortlessly through the steps of fuzzy logic system design. So this the toolbox can be customized, the algorithm can be edited, the can add membership function and edit the variables and defuzzification techniques implication, and these methods are available in the toolbox. And this toolbox consists of these editors: membership function editor, rule editor, rule viewer, and the surface viewer, fuzzy logic controller block. This is the snapshot of the fuzzy logic toolbox. It consists of the menu like file, edit, and all that. The input is given, and this is the fuzzy logic function, membership function blocks, and the output is obtained. And there are various options available like AND, OR, implication, and all. There exists a drop down list for AND, like minimum product and OR, maximum sum, etc. Then the output is obtained, and by using that edit, we can edit the membership function. This is the snapshot obtained by snapshot of the membership function editor, and this one is the snapshot of the membership function implementation rule. So this is the rule editor. So by using this tool, the learning can be easier, but because if we use pen and paper to calculate the fuzzy two, then it will be very difficult, and the calculation will be very, very lengthy, and it deals with lots of decimal numbers.